It's not even funny, dude.
So, Coach, how strong is Westview this year?
A lot stronger than we are.
You already written Friday night down as a loss, Brock?
Well, not if I know we could beat them.
Come here, Brock. You too, Jeremy.
What, am I in trouble now?
Not yet. I want to see you do the death crawl again, except I want to see your absolute best.
What, you want me to go to the 30?
I think you can go to the 50.
50? I can go to the 50 if nobody's on my back.
I think you can do it with Jeremy on your back. But even if you can, I want you to promise me you're going to do your best.
All right.
Your best.
Okay.
You going to give me your best?
I'm going to give you my best.
All right, one more thing. I want you to do it blindfolded.
Why?
Because I don't want you giving up at a certain point when you could go further. Get down. Jeremy, get on his back. Now get a good tight hold, Jeremy. All right. Let's go, Brock. Keep your knees off the ground. Just your hands and feet. There you go. A little bit left. A little bit left.
I bet he got it.
There you go. Show me good effort. Keep moving, Brock. That's it. That's it. That's it. Keep going.
I want everything you got. Come on, keep going.
It hurts.
Don't quit on me. Your very best. Keep driving. Keep driving. There you go. There you go.
He's heavy.
I know he's heavy.
I'm bad out of strength.
Then you negotiate with your body to find more strength, but don't you give up on me, Brock. You keep going, you hear me? You keep going. You're doing good. You keep going. Do not quit on me. You keep going.
It hurts.
I know it hurts. You keep going. You keep going. It's all hard from here. 30 more steps. You keep going, Brock. Come on. Keep going.
Burn.
And let it burn.
My arms are burning.
It's all hard. You keep going, Brock. Come on. Come on. Keep going. You promised me your best. Your best. Don't stop. Keep going.
Too hard.
It's not too hard. You keep going. Come on, Brock. Give me more. Give me more. Keep going. 20 more steps. 20 more. Keep going, Brock. Give me your best. Don't quit. No. Keep going. Keep going. Keep going. Don't quit. Don't quit. Don't quit. Brock Kelly, you don't quit. Keep going. Keep going. Go, Brock Kelly. You don't quit on me. No, you keep going. You keep going. Go, Brock. 10 more steps. 10 more. 10 more. 10 more. Keep going. Don't quit. Give me your heart. You can. You can. 5 more. 5 more. Come on, Brock. Come on. Don't quit. Don't quit. Come on, Brock. 2 more. 1 more.
Let's go. 50. Let's go to the 50. I'll have any more.
Look up, Brock. You're in the end zone.
In this scene, the young man that was carrying his teammate was on his back, had the faith to believe that he could carry him to the 50-yard line. But as he crawled further down the field, he became increasingly tired and fatigued, to the point that he was ready to give up. But yet he endured until the end. This, unfortunately, is how we can become, this is how we become as we travel along our Christian journey. At times we faced obstacle after obstacle after obstacle, along with the emotional weight, stress, pressure, and the heartache that comes with it. When this occurs, we too can get to the point that we lose faith and feel like giving up. Here's my title and encouragement for today's message. As you go through what you're going through, don't let it break you. Don't let it break you. It gets tough. It gets hard. It gets discouraging. There will be times that you will feel like giving up. But don't let it break you. You've heard the phrase bend, but don't break. Don't let it break you. You've got to keep fighting even when you feel like stopping, when you feel like quitting. You've got to continue to move forward. Amen. Somebody say, don't let it break you. Turn to your neighbor and say, don't let it break you. 1 Corinthians chapter 10, verse number 13. 1 Corinthians 10, 13. The Bible says, no trial has overtaken you that is not faced by others. This is in the God's Word translation. No trial has overtaken you that is not faced by others. And God is faithful. Somebody say, God is faithful. I love the way that it stops, and it's almost like it takes a turn, and it says, but in spite of that, God is faithful. No trial is overtaken you that is not faced by others, and God is faithful. He will not let you be tried beyond what you're able to bear. But with the trial will also provide a way out so that you will be able to endure it. But God is faithful. But God is faithful. There are four ways in this verse that the Apostle Paul used to encourage the Corinthian church. I want to use those same methods that the Apostle Paul used to encourage every person in this room, especially those of you that feel like that guy felt. You've moved, you've pushed, you've crawled, you've scratched, but yet storm after storm after storm after storm hits you head on. Here's my encouragement to you, which is what the Apostle Paul used. He used four things to encourage the Corinthian church. I want to give you those same methods, those same words of encouragement. Here's number one. Paul said, no trial has overtaken you that is not faced by others. No trial has overtaken you that is not faced with others. For some reason, I think we find encouragement knowing that if somebody else is going through what you've gone through, it gives you just a little bit more strength and courage to move forward. Is that just me? I mean, I know it's not always a good thing, but if you're going through a battle or some kind of situation is tough, but somebody else is beside you, it gives you a little bit more encouragement. It gives you something to hold on to. No trial has overtaken you that is not faced by others. In essence, Paul was saying this right here. You're not the only one that's ever faced something like this. If they overcame it, so will you. You're not the only one that has gone through what you're going through right now. If they overcame it, so will you. Well, preacher, how do you know? Because the Bible says God is no respecter of persons. If God has done it for them, God will do it for you. If God has done it for them, God will do it for you. 2 Corinthians chapter 2, verse 14, the Bible says, now thanks be unto God. I love the next phrase, which always causeth us to triumph in Christ and maketh manifest the Savior of his knowledge by us in every place. Yeah. Now thanks be unto who? God. Now thanks be unto who? God. You guys can say it a little bit louder than that. Now thanks be unto who? Now, thanks be unto God, which always, not most of the time, not part of the time, not just when he feels like it, but thanks be unto God, which always causes us to triumph in Christ. Always means always. Here's the second thing in that verse that we found that the Apostle Paul shared with the Corinthian church. He said, and God is faithful. When you're going through what you're going through, you need to know that God is going to be faithful to his word. If God has told you that he will never leave you nor forsake you, God needs to be faithful. I want you to know this day that God is faithful. Paul said, even when we're unfaithful, God abideth faithful. And God is faithful. Somebody say, God is faithful. Who in this room can say God has not been faithful to me in my life? Not one person can truthfully raise their hand. There are times in our life where we feel like God isn't faithful. There are times in our life where we question God, where are you? We question God, why did you not answer my prayer? But God is faithful. Paul was saying, no matter how difficult things appear to be, and notice I said appear to be, I say appear to be because sometimes things aren't as bad as the way we feel. Our emotions take over. And sometimes we can magnify how big the situation might be. You've heard people say, don't make a mountain out of a molehill. But sometimes when you're going through what you're going through, that molehill can seem like a mountain. Paul was saying, no matter how difficult things appear to be, who's against you or how discouraging you might be, God's got it. God's got this. No matter how big it might be, no matter how discouraged you might be, God's got this. No matter who's against you, God's got this. Somebody say, he's got it. You need peace? God's got it. You need strength? God's got it. You need deliverance? God's got it. You need joy unspeakable? God's got it. Whatever you're in need of, God's got it. Somebody say amen. Amen. Isaiah chapter 40, verse number 31, the Bible says, but they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. Whatever it is that you're in need of, God's got it. Here's the third thing I found in that verse that I want you to see today. He will not let you be tried beyond what you're able to bear. How many of you have said, God, I can't take anymore. God, I can't take another step. God, I can't go another minute. God, how much more do you expect me to endure? I don't know about you, but I've been there. I've done that. I've said that. God, how much more? God, why is this happening to me, especially right now? God's in control. But here's the deal. God will not let you be tried beyond what you're able to bear. Have you ever wondered, God, are you sure you know what you're doing? God, am I stronger than what I realize I am? God, am I weaker than you think I am? God, am I weaker than you think? God, are you sure that I can handle this? Because, Lord, I didn't think I could handle what I went through already. But yet, here this comes now. By the way, God doesn't do those things. God doesn't send battles your way. God doesn't bring calamity upon you. God doesn't strike your body with ailments. God doesn't do bad things to his people. Can I get a witness? God doesn't do bad things to his people. The enemy does bad things to God's people, and we put ourselves in bad situations and have to face the consequences of our actions. But even when we put ourselves in bad situations and face those bad consequences, God can still use them to bring us out, to bring us to a level of maturity so that we can know him in a greater way and that he will be glorified. So God, you use my calamities to be glorified? So God, you mean to tell me that in the mess that I go through, you mean to tell me that you receive glory in all of this? You best believe that he does. The Bible says, in all things, give thanks to God. In all things, not think, oh God, praise God. Battle after battle, I love these battles. Nobody says that. And that's not what God is saying. God is saying by faith, give thanks unto God. Why? Because by faith, I'm going to overcome. He will not let you be tried beyond what you're able to bear. In essence, Paul was saying, although you feel deserted, even by God at times. Notice I said feel. Sometimes our feelings aren't always accurate. Sometimes your feelings will keep you in places that you don't need to be. Sometimes your feelings will keep you in the house when you need to be at church. Sometimes your feelings will keep you at the house when you need to be at church. I've been there, and so have you. Sometimes your feelings will keep you from calling out, calling on the name of the Lord to help you while you're going through what you're going through. Sometimes your feelings will say, this is all God's fault. Paul was saying, although you feel deserted even by God at times, you feel that you can't go any further, you feel like things are only getting worse, you must understand that God created you. Therefore, he knows what and how much you can handle. God knows everything there is to be known about you. Therefore, God knows exactly what you can handle. He knows exactly what you cannot handle. God knows everything there is to be known about everything. Matthew chapter 20, verses 29 through 31. Matthew 10, verses 29 through 31, the Bible says, and this is Jesus speaking. Jesus said, are not two sparrows sold for a penny? And one of them shall not fall to the ground without your heavenly Father knowing about it. Not one of them shall fall to the ground without your heavenly Father knowing about it. But the very hairs of your head are all numbered. How many of you guys know the number of hairs that are on top of your head? Not a soul in this place. Even for those of you that shave your head, God knows how many pores that you've got there. He knows the pores that are there. Jesus said, not one sparrow shall fall to the earth without me knowing about it. He says, but the very hairs that are on your head are all numbered. Fear you not, therefore, ye are of more value than many sparrows. So God is comparing us to a sparrow, saying, don't worry about that. If I know what's going on with the sparrow, I know what's going on with you. So don't think that you're going through this by yourself, because everything that you're going through, I know about. Well, God, if you know I'm going through this mess, if you see me crying, if you see me broken, if you see me all of these things, then why in the world don't you come and see about me? God doesn't have to come and see about you. God's already there being about you. He don't have to come. He's already there. He's omnipresent. He's everywhere all at the same time. Well, God, if you see me going through this, and God, if you see me broken, God, you see me wounded and ready to give up, why don't you just stop it? That's a valid question, isn't it? God, why don't you just speak a word and it's gone? God has the power to do it, doesn't he? I can't answer that question because I've asked God at times in my life, God, why don't you just stop the pain? God, just answer my prayer. Just, God, move in a miraculous way. And sometimes it doesn't happen always right then. But as the songwriter said, he may not come when you want him, but he'll be there right on time, because he's an on-time God. Oh, yes, he is. You know, we don't like this, but a lot of our growth comes in the valley. A lot of our growth comes through the valley. Your faith is elevated, not on the mountaintop. The mountaintop is just the manifestation of your victory. But your growth comes while you're in the valley. But you're saying, God, throw me a rope. Let me climb up this mountain. I'm tired of being in the valley. It's hard to trust God sometimes, isn't it? And I know I won't get a whole lot of amens on that, because that's not very spiritual to say. Preacher, how dare you say it's hard to trust God? God is trustworthy. He is. But just because he's trustworthy doesn't mean it's not difficult for us to trust God. Do you know why it's hard for us to trust God? Because sometimes we don't see the whole picture always. But yet and still, God is trustworthy. But it's difficult to trust God. That kind of reminds me of this story that I heard a while back. There was a guy that was hiking up on this huge mountain. And this guy slid down. And man, as he was just tumbling down, he reached out and grabbed this branch, the only branch on the side of that mountain. He was holding on for dear life. And his body weight alone was just making his fingers just turn red. And all of a sudden, this man turns and he looks and he says, God, if you're out there, please help me, help me, help me. God says, turn loose of the branch and just trust me. The man says, is there anybody else out there? Out there? Out there? Trust in God. Trust in God is a challenge. But yet God is trustworthy. Yet God is trustworthy. Somebody say, he's trustworthy. God is trustworthy. Number four. Here's the last thing that I found in that verse that the Apostle Paul used to encourage the Corinthians that I'm using today to encourage you. But with the trial, we'll also provide a way out so that you may be able to endure it. But with the trial, we'll also, he's talking about God. God will give you a way. God will provide a way so that you can endure that situation. See, it's not always about getting out of it. It's not always about getting out. Sometimes I just need strength to get through it. Sometimes I need the strength and the mindset to trust God while I'm going through. Somebody heard this, or somebody sings a song, don't know how all the words, but it's not a song, it's a phrase. God's a prayer answering God. And he is a prayer answering God. And then it goes on to say, prayer changes things. You've heard that, right? Prayer does change things. But see, not only does prayer change things, but sometimes God won't answer that prayer or change that, but he will change the way you see that thing. Prayer changes things, but God can also touch you where you change the way you see that situation. Prayer changes things. Amen. He opens up our eyes. But with the trial will also provide a way out so that you may be able to endure it. What was Paul saying? Paul was saying, although you're going through an extremely challenging, difficult time, God will be with you every step of the way. In fact, he's going to guide you through this. Just trust him. Just trust him. Although you're going through an extremely challenging, difficult time, God will be with you every step of the way. In fact, he's going to guide you through this, whatever it is. What you and I have to do, again, is just trust him. Here's my final verse, Proverbs chapter 3, verses 5 and 6, which happens to be my favorite scripture in the entire Bible. Trust in the Lord. Stop right there. Trust in the Lord. Sometimes you can get bad information from your buddies, from your friends. Sometimes they can have good intentions. They mean well, but sometimes it's not always the best advice. We need godly counsel, don't we? Trust in, not your pastor. I want you to trust me, but don't trust in me. Trust in the Lord with all thine heart, and lean not into thine own understanding, but in all thy ways acknowledge him, and he shall direct thy paths. Can you say it with me? Trust in the Lord, with all thine heart, and lean not into thine own understanding. In all thy ways, not most of thy ways, but in all thy ways, acknowledge him, and he shall direct thy paths. Is God a God of his word? Does God mean what he say and say what he means? Is God a liar? Absolutely not. God is a man that he cannot lie. If God says it, God means it. If God says it, you and I need to expect it. We need to believe that he's going to do it. Even when you've crawled the last 10 yards, the last 10 yards, and another storm sideswipes you, something takes your breath away, that's not the moment to quit. That's the moment to keep moving forward. That's the moment to dig your heels in the dirt and go a little bit further. You might slow down. You might get discouraged. You may even shed a few tears. You might think about turning back around. You might feel like collapsing. You may think about collapsing right where you are. But that is not God. You see that coach sitting there encouraging him like that? Don't stop. Don't stop. Keep coming. Keep coming. We've got a coach named Coach Holy Spirit. Do you hear that? We've got a coach that won't let you down. We've got a coach that doesn't get thirsty. We've got a coach that won't leave you out on the field by yourself. We've got a coach that doesn't need a break. We've got a coach called the Holy Spirit that's saying, keep coming. Keep coming. Don't quit. Don't quit. Don't give up. I'm going to lead you to the place of peace. Weeping may endure for a night, but joy comes in the morning. We serve a coach by the name of Holy Spirit. that will bring the Word of God back to your heart. We serve a coach called the Holy Spirit that will remind you of where you've come from. And if God did it for you back then, that same God will do it for you right now. The Holy Spirit will say to you, He's the same yesterday, today, and forever. He changes not. I leave this with you. Let's go back to my title. Whatever it is you're faced with today, don't let it break you. That's the intention of it, but don't let it break you. Notice I said don't let it. Don't let it. I say don't let it because it, the storms, the battles, whatever you're going through, does not possess the power to break you. The Bible says that no weapon formed against you shall prosper. We have weapons. No weapon formed against you shall be able to prosper, which means it can't break you. If you stop, it's on you. It's because you gave up. It's not because you don't have the inner strength to do it. It's not because you don't possess the inner power to keep moving until you overcome. And friends, let me share this with you. During those times where you feel like collapsing, God Himself, through the power of the Holy Spirit, will carry you through. He will carry you through. And does that mean that you can just give up in His arms and just don't have faith anymore? Absolutely not. You've got to keep working. The Bible says faith without works are dead. Don't let it break you. Every head bowed and every eye closed, I'm going to ask that nobody look around.